Welcome to another video of STM32 Microcontroller series. In this video, we'll learn how to connect LCD to STM32 board, or simply we'll be interfacing 16-bit LCD to STM32. So let's get started. So here is a connection diagram. We have used PB10 and PB11 to connect with RS and EN pin. Similarly, we have used PA4, PA3, PA2 and PA1 to connect to pin number 11, 12, 13 and 14. Similarly, we have used a 10 kilo ohm potentiometer to control the brightness, and we have supplied 5 volt to LCD using the supply of STM32. So we have assembled the same circuit on breadboard like this. So you can see we have supplied 5 volt from the STM32 board, and you can also see pin number A4, A3, A2 and A1 is connected to LCD pin 11, 12, 13, 14. And similarly, we have also used PA10, PB10 and PB11 to connect to RS and EN pins. So this is how it is connected. So let's move to the programming section. So this is the header file. That is the header file for liquid crystal. And after that, we have just defined the pin using constant int, that is defined according to the circuit diagram. Like we have defined RS2 PB11 and EN2 PB10. Similarly, you can see D4 is PA4, D5 is PA3, D6 is PA2 and D7 is PA1. So after this line, we have just initialized the LCD using liquid crystal LCD command. So after that, you can see we have a void setup. That is how we have set up the LCD. So LCD 16,2 is defining as LCD pins. Means it has 16 rows and 2 columns. This is defining the row number and column number. That is 0,0. After that, interfacing LCD will be displayed. After that, we have moved to row 0 and column 1. Here width STM32 board will be displayed. We have supplied a delay of 4 seconds, that is 4000 milliseconds. LCD.clear is used to clear the screen. So you can see now void loop will be continuously printing the data. So we have defined row 0 and column 0. Here it will be displaying STM32 with LCD. So we have set LCD set cursor as 0,1. So here we have used a millis function to display the number. So we have divided it by 1000 so that number 1, 2, 3, 4 will be appearing. So before compiling the code, you need to select certain parameters. So first go to the file and select preference. Here you need to have installed STM32 board earlier. Check our previous video how to install STM32 board. Click on tools and select the board. So currently we are using STM32F103C series board. So select this. We are using a variant of 128 kilo flash. Upload method is STM32 Duno bootloader. You can use serial method and STLink method if you have STLink debugger or USB-TTL converter. CPU speed is 72 MHz. This is smallest. Port will appear once you connect the port. So I am uploading it directly via USB, mini USB port. So COM7 Maple Mini is appearing here. So now simply compile the code. So code was easy and small. So it successfully compiled. So once the compilation is done, you can upload the same code. So I am uploading it. So while uploading, you will see something that how it is uploaded is printed at the bottom. So it is done. So you can see the result, how it has erased the previous data and it has written the new data. So you can see what is displayed on LCD, interfacing LCD with STM32 board. And after 4 seconds, it will be displaying the timings with STM32 with LCD display. So you can use the potentiometer to increase or decrease the brightness and clarity on LCD.